when you're happy with the dry side, that you've got it lined up in the center, then you can do the other side. Replace the thicker one for the thinner one. Offer it up again. Now the crank is held against the dry side by the cush dry spring anyway, but if you can do your best to limit the end float to the minimum, I'll swap that round again. I'll put the thicker one on this time. And when you're happy with the dry side, that you've got it lined up in the center, then you can do the other side. Replace the thicker one for the thinner one. Offer it up again. Now the crank is held against the dry side by the cush dry spring anyway, but if you can do your best to limit the end float to the minimum, I'll swap that round again. I'll put the thicker one on this time. What I am going to do here as well, before I put these and tighten up these tie bolts, I'm going to put the cylinder on and I'm going to tighten that, because these two crank halves were from different engines, they're not matched at all. So just to make sure that the mating surface is absolutely level, I'm going to do that up now. The crank is still free to rotate. Then I'm going to nip up the little tie bolts, not fully tight, don't do that yet, but tight enough so it doesn't all start moving around when I get the engine in the frame. So I'll take the cylinder off and drop the crankcase in the frame. Okay. A little bit on the inside edge. Not too much, because it's pointless, it just gets squidged out of the gap. That's not doing anything except potentially blocking up the oil waste. So when you've got a little thin smear of that over it, just wipe off any excess, because it will squidge about anyway. The end of the shaft there, that'll take all that off. Now this stuff stays sort of semi-sticky, it's very good. It's better than red hermatite. Hermatite's alright, and well seal's alright. This is much better. And they claim it's the same formulation that they use to assemble new engines. And it's also a neutral colour. And although red hermatite is alright, it does a very good job. You can see it, and it looks like something's been bodged. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Bits inside will remove now. No excess. Stick this on here. And after you've stuck that on, before you put the outer casing on, don't forget the small paper washer that goes over. Pick up from the sump. Now your half time pinion is the only left hand thread on the engine. So just brace your crankshaft like that to stop it from turning. Now it needs to be tight, obviously, but don't go mental, because the engine turns the other way, so it's not going to loosen. If anything, it will get tighter. So that's tight. And while we're in here, I decided to replace the spindle, the cam follower spindle. The two I've got, this came with an exploded bottom end, it's quite badly worn, and it was used with these followers, very wobbly. This is one that were in the used crankcases here that I've had for 30 years, possibly more. But since they're cheap enough anyway, I've put a new one in. start putting things together. Lubricate it with a bit of oil. I usually use the oil that I'm going to run in the engine, but it doesn't matter, it's only for assembly. And thoughts on some cams. This is usable. I bought this off eBay. I don't have the forked followers for it, so I won't use it. I was going to use this one and buy some regular followers, because this is quite usable, but this came with my exploded bottom end that I bought for parts, and it did yield some usable parts, especially the followers. Now this has been built up on the bottom. I think we've touched up on this subject before. It's been taken off on the bottom to make the base circle smaller, which in effect has given it a higher lift, and I would say it's probably had a good 2 millimeters, as much as that, maybe 1.5 millimeters removed, and you won't see it on this basic camera. But the cam followers have been built up with some kind of hard facing to make up for it. So these are the ones I'm going to be using. So what we're going to do is line up our timing dots. One there that you can't see, and one there between the teeth. This one that you can't see is on the teeth, this is between them. I've chamfered the inside of the piston at the bottom to an edge so it will skim the oil off of the cylinder wall and direct it up towards the gouging pin. It's a nice tight fit. What I'm going to do is apply a little bit of heat to this, warm it up. check the piston rings to make sure that they don't have a upside and a downside. They're absolutely identical. And gaps all sort of equidistant, so it's all the way around. One there, and one at the back. In fact, not at the back, it's the thrust face, but and again, a little bit of assembly oil. Going to spread some gasket glue on the other face. When I was younger, I'd just buy a gasket set and I'd fit the gaskets. Now, not really paying any attention to part numbers. Now these pushrod seals are two different part numbers, and they are, do actually look different. There's a thinner and narrower. What goes where? Why does it matter? Maybe the thinner ones should go at the bottom. But in the Britax Decoke set that I've got, both rubbers are exactly the same. They're quite tight on the bottom. Easy to fit on the top. And they're still going to squash up no matter what. So, I wonder why that is. Would know. Well, I'm sure people know, but I'm not really worried. I'm just going to put these on the way they fit best. And the way these fit best is with the smaller, narrower ones at the bottom. The bigger ones at the top. There doesn't seem to be any rhyme or reason in that anyway, because this one's just as tight the other way round. Right, there we go. I'm not worried about the dodgy chrome on these when I pop it apart to decoke it. I'll put stainless ones on. Right, nice little job. Head. Let's pull that lock back on. Just make sure the fuel tank sits on properly because the engine's a bit taller, so I'm going to have to put some more rubber spacers on top of it. Now I'll do the timing and I'll see how it starts. I'm going to use the original 350 carb at the moment, the 176, whatever it is, 275, 276. Just to start it up, because with my 32mm concentric, I think it will touch the oil tank, but I'll have yet to try. Right, it's over the top dead. Giving it a little tickle. First kick.